What is AES 256-bit encryption and how exactly does it work? Hey everyone, Alex Mullen here with today's BizTech Tips. And AES 256-bit encryption is actually the most secure commercially available encryption method. And AES, it stands for Advanced Encryption Standard. And first, the way it works is it's something called symmetric encryption. And that just means it uses one key to both cipher and decipher the data. And 256 bits refers to essentially how many different combinations there are for possibly ciphering and deciphering things. But I don't think you can fully appreciate what's going on there until you know what the whole process looks like. So first you have some bit of data. So maybe let's just envision a Word document, right? We'll keep it kind of straightforward with characters, right? So the data, it actually gets divided into 4x4 blocks. So it's not just straight moving one character to another. So it's not like every time A comes up, you know, G or whatever it is how it switches. And it's not even two characters, right? So every time you see AA, you know, it's not like CZ is the translation or AB is then DQ or whatever it might be, which already for our brains already starts to get kind of crazy. So again, what it is, it's 4x4 blocks. So it's four different data points with four different rows on top of them too. Now what it does is it takes that little 4x4 block and it does something called key expansion. And so each little block gets expanded by this. It gets run against an algorithm. And now there's a whole other 4x4 block that might have two characters that all tie back to the original 4x4. And now what happens is you actually take those two 4x4 blocks and you add them together. And you might wonder, well, how do you add letters? Remember, at its core, all the letters and everything in a computer, it's ones and zeros. So whether it's letters, numbers, sounds, pictures, videos, whatever it is, it's a whole string of ones and zeros. So it's this whole long string of ones and zeros that refer back to that. That's what's getting added together. And so what happens with this, if you had one-bit encryption, that would mean you have this whole long string that's now been complicatedly added together that I just mentioned. One-bit encryption would be either a one or a zero being applied to each one of these. Two bits would mean that there are four different combinations for each little bit there. And then four would be 16. But again, this is 256-bit, which actually is the equivalent of 1.1 times 10 to the 77th power of options for each bit that we just complicatedly put together already. So that's pretty crazy. So you might think this would be enough, but computers are actually super fast these days. So after that, each byte, which is a byte is 8 bits, each byte is translated into another seemingly random byte after all of that. Then the AES encryption method, it takes all these different rows and strings of data and it shifts each row over by a different amount. So what each of those are is now different too. And then after that, the columns are mixed together by multiplying each column by a predefined matrix that's using some pretty high-level mathematics. And all of that is then added onto the original step number two key expansion. So if you remember what we did there, all of that happens all over again. And all of these steps is considered one round. And AES 256-bit encryption does 13 of those different rounds. And so that's how it hides it, and then that's how it breaks it all down there too. So what that means, if you try to brute force break this level of encryption with today's computers, even taking the world's fastest supercomputer, it would literally take millions of years. So do you know what happens after all of this encryption and high-level stuff goes on, actually? Someone in your company, they set their password as password or send their banking information to a Nigerian prince and the whole company gets screwed anyways. So keep that in mind. That's why when password strength and all this other stuff really comes into it too, because again, the encryption is just such high level right now. So hopefully you learned something. Let me know if you did down below or if you have questions or anything like that. And have a good one, everyone.